I'm here with one of the most popular fighters in San Antonio, stormed by hundreds of fans. How many pictures did ishe Sugar Smith take today?
Man, I don't even know. A bunch. You know, they showed me a lot of love. I definitely appreciate it. It was a good night, good fight. Man, I'd love to fight here one day.
What did you think of Canelo Trout?
I thought that's the best Canelo ever looked. I mean, he fought a good fight. I picked Trout slightly. I had it close, 55-45, but, you know, Canelo surprised me, man. He fought real well. He dictated the ring. Trout didn't disappoint either, but Canelo was just on tonight. Trout had an off night. Canelo was just on, man.
I spoke to two people right after the fight, to trainer Steven Edwards. He told me after this fight, maybe Mayweather will want to fight Canelo because based on what he saw. And then Larry Merchant told me there's no way Mayweather will fight Canelo. What do you think?
Well, it's not about Mayweather wanting to fight Canelo. Now, Mayweather's the best in the business. He's number one. He's not going to have Canelo dictating any terms. And that's just the thing. Canelo shouldn't be able to dictate no terms. And people got to understand that. And Mayweather's not going to have anybody dictate to him anything. When they fight, what day they fight, are we going to fight next? And that's the problem. Mayweather already had this fight scheduled with Guerrero, and Canelo wanted a promise that they was going to fight his next fight. And Floyd's not going to make that promise to anybody. So I don't think Floyd's scared or don't want to fight anybody. He's 43-0 for the reason. He's the best for the reason. So people just got to understand that. And the fight, if it's going to happen, it'll happen. If it's not, then it's not. End of story.
ishe, Canelo surprised a lot of people tonight with his slickness. That's usually reserved for slick African-American fighters. What do you think about the way he was moving in there?
I think he was just moving more on instinct more than anything. He was just moving. I don't think it was nothing planned or nothing like slick about it. I just think he was moving, getting out of the way of punches, and it worked for him. I wouldn't say he'll be able to do that against a good counterpuncher or a good boxer. You know, like I said, I take my hats off to him. He fought a good fight.
What's next for you?
Finishing up this deal with Molina, and hopefully, you know, after that, you know, finish this deal up with Molina. Finish that off first, and maybe, who knows, cinnamon and sugar. Who knows?
Last time I was at your gym, you guys gave a little hard time to Zach Cooper. He took a vacation after 3 days. He said, I didn't take a vacation. I went to take care of business. I was training.
He wasn't training, man. He was on vacation. He
wasn't training. And Mike Rude, the same thing. Mike says, I'm there every day. What are they talking about?
Man, Mike Rude have the longest pro debut I ever seen in my life. I got to figure out what's going on.
Any message to your fans if they're watching?
Thank you guys for the support. Definitely thank San Antonio, man. I loved it out here. I've had a ball. It's time to get back to work. Be looking for me and Carlos Molina. The announcement any day now. Hopefully Leonard finishes it up.
Is it still the same situation? Because last time we did the video, you said he's scared of you.
Scared of him?
That's what he said in the video.
Man, please. He's supposed to be my bodyguard here. He can't even protect himself.
There you have it. ishe Smith, look out for him. EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Lasik, back reporting.